Just days after the murder on August 16, 1969, Manson and 26 members of his family were arrested in a daybreak raid on Spahn Ranch. They were charged with auto theft. But to the authorities' surprise, they'd also found an arsenal of weapons. The police had no idea who they had arrested, or that there was any connection between them and the Tate-LaBianca murders. Almost all those arrested in the raid had given false names, and to make matters worse, the warrant had been misdated. A day later, all the suspects were released to roam free again.
Charlie just burst into this room of Dennis's one night and with his hair looking just wildly out on end, jumped into the room and said, "I just come from the moon."
Charlie had a .45 and he said, and he loaded it and played with the bullets, loaded the gun, and he like pointed the gun at Dennis and said, "What would you do if I pulled the trigger?"
And Dennis got him out of the house as quickly as he could, and then came back in and was white as a ghost, and he told me he threatened to kidnap my son.
Whatever is necessary to do, you do it. When somebody needs to be killed, there's no wrong, you do it. And then you move on. And you pick up a child, and you move him to the desert. You pick up as many children as you can. And you kill whoever gets in your way. This is us.
The eagle flies, we will lie.
Charlie and the family embarked on their exodus to the desert, where he was able to pay off Ma Barker, owner of the Barker Ranch on the outskirts of Death Valley National Park, with a gold record of the Beach Boys Today LP that Dennis had given him. To further entice Barker of his credibility, Manson claimed that he was the composer and arranger for the Beach Boys. And at that, tenancy to reside on the ranch was granted to him.
The sun and the moon in your hands, your head in the sky. Never ask why love never dies. Love never.
I answered the front doorbell. There were two Los Angeles Police Department detectives. He showed me their identification and asked if they could come in and speak to me, and I said yes. And they actually, what they said was this. They said, and this is really a very strange moment, and they said, "Do you know anybody who would want to kill you?" That's exactly what they said.
"This is my music, you little bitch." The people were at that ranch was mad at Terry Melcher because he didn't do what he said, number one. Number two, he sent somebody over there to fight. Mm-hmm. He caused some trouble. He almost got some other people killed. Mm-hmm. Some people put their life on the line because of Terry Melcher. Mm-hmm. And he wanted to fight. I told him, "I don't want to fight." I said, "Bruce, you want to fight this guy? You fight him. I'm not going to fight him." I ducked him and ran behind the barn. I don't want to fight him.
These past few months were a living nightmare for Dennis, who one night awoke and saw that there were people in his room holding knives over him and his wife, Barbara. Then the shadowy figures of the creepy crawlers disappeared into the darkness, laughing maniacally.
And as things began to unfold, I think Dennis was fearful that those people did have something to do with those things, even though nobody had directly said to him, "Oh, they did this or they did that."
He was now shattered, afraid, paranoid. In his room, wouldn't come out, couldn't do anything.
So Dennis and Terry Melcher fled to an isolated cabin 100 miles away from the city in Lake Arrowhead. On October 12, 1969, police executed a raid on Barker Ranch. Authorities found Manson hidden in a tiny cupboard. They also found several stolen vehicles, a single-shot pistol, and knives. 10 female and 3 males were arrested. The prisoners were handcuffed, and on the way to Independence, Manson had told police that the blacks were going to take over the country and that he and his group only wanted to find a quiet, peaceful place away from the conflict.
He stressed that we, in uniform, number one, were cops, number two, we were white, therefore we had two strikes against us immediately, and he strongly recommended that we let them go and we flee for our lives.